cause of anxiety, lack of faith. The grass has a message. Jesus said, "If then God so clothes the grass which today is in the field and tomorrow is thrown into the oven," meaning these things which are insignificant and will be thrown into the trash after a couple days, the Lord goes on to give them a beautiful appearance, though their final destination is the fire. How much more will he clothe you, O you of little faith? Did that green grass ask to have a nice looking appearance? No. Did that green grass strive hard so it could have a nice looking appearance? No. Did the green grass sit and think to itself, "I wonder when will my life end?" Also no. However, it still had a nice looking appearance, meaning it didn't ask, it didn't strive, and it didn't think. Nevertheless, God beautifies it. So the first message from the world of vegetation is, how much more for you? I wish every time we see a tree, or a plant, or a flower, we hear their message. They're telling you one thing, stop worrying. That's the message. Every tree is saying, stop worrying, because I didn't make myself. If my appearance looks nice to you, I have no virtue. I didn't think, I didn't strive, I didn't ask. The thinking, the striving, the asking, the reckoning, and all of that possibly has no purpose. The second thing, Jesus said, how much more will he clothe you, O you of little faith? So our Lord Jesus gave us a candid principle. Whenever anxiety or worry is present, spiritually this means that faith is lacking. Don't say the world is on fire. No, no, no. It's lack of faith. Don't say the people are bad or whatever reason you come up with. In the end, the root reason for anxiety is lack of faith. There has never been a time in the world when the people were good and when life was calm or when this or that. No, no. Every era had evil and devils and traps and incidents. This is the nature of the world. Even so, there are people living tranquilly, in tranquility, happy lives, having fun, not worrying. And there are people who are professional warriors, though they live in the same circumstances. So the issue is relative. It depends on you, not on those around you. My beloved children, we have a disaster in our minds. We're waiting for the circumstances to be fixed so that our worrying can be adjusted back. It's not going to be adjusted. For example, the supervisor that was bothering you, he gets removed. Most likely, you'll get removed after him, or they'll get you another supervisor just like him. What's the difference? Or maybe the supervisor that comes is good, but the coworkers will turn out to be bane. This is normal. Or let's say you went to live in a calm area. You left the bad area. You'll get yourself a neighbor that's not calm. All this means that this is what the nature of the world is like. If you're trying to arrive at a state of calmness and no worries by waiting for your circumstances to change, then you are chasing a mirage. That's a big deception. It's not going to happen. Don't wait for your outside circumstances to change, not your health, for example. Even if you got better, thank God, but you'll get sick again. God gives us health and all, but you know, this is all normal. This world is like that. The cure to anxiety comes from inside, not from outside. That's the first important message. You worry not because of the circumstances or because of people, it's because of your mind. The problem is inside, lack of faith. He said, "Oh, you of little faith." Jesus didn't say we were not believers, but he had a precise diagnosis, that is, little in faith, meaning the faith needs to increase and be more than what it is. The current level of faith I have isn't enough to stop the worrying, because I worry about my kids more than what's right. Well, those are his children. Weren't they baptized? They're more precious to him than they are to you. They are more precious to him than they are to you. Why are you not willing to believe this? Or your eternity is consuming you. You might tell me, "I'm so worried about the salvation of my soul." That statement is wrong in the first place. The salvation of your soul produces anxiety? This anxiety you're having is counter to your soul's salvation. And God is busy with your salvation more than you are. I'm not telling you don't strive, but take it easy on yourself a bit. Your eternity is more important to Him than it is to you. Overthinking is lack of faith. Troubled thinking is lack of faith. Thinking using lots of numbers is lack of faith. Our Lord Jesus doesn't hate numbers, but Jesus has numbers completely different from ours. His 5 will bring about 5,000. He'll have 12 that suffices for the entire world. He has weird calculations. We don't quite understand how his computer works, but you go on calculating, you have 1,000 pounds and you try to figure out what it'll be enough for. Then you discover that you spend it all in just 2 weeks. Come on now, why are you thinking like that? As long as you're calculating it with numbers like that, this is lack of faith. The issue is bigger than that. Thinking without praying is lack of faith. If you're thinking more than you're praying, you're lacking in faith. The words, "do not worry," are a commandment. My beloved children, a commandment that, in my opinion, all of us are breaking. And by the way, we're not repenting. Rarely does someone come to me in confession and say, "I have the sin of anxiety or a worry." I don't think anyone thinks that to say this, but it's a sin, by the way. Put it on the list, please. Let each one of you put it on your list of sins. Definitely it's a sin. Isn't there a commandment? So the opposite of it is a sin.